Greetings again, Two Strike fans, and welcome to all new subscribers. I hope you get something out of these videos. At the moment, this series covers Two Strike expansion chambers, the secrets of them, and I'll explain that in time, but another objective is giving you enough basic information so that you can make choices looking at expansion chambers and doing modifications to your own ones without going into too much science, because there is some fundamentals. So far we've done a couple of videos. I suggest you go back over those. I will be referring to them. In the previous video we covered the subject of measuring the expansion chamber and the lengths of the actual cones using a formula by putting a ruler down the side, and I'll jump into the software shortly and show you those calculations that I've done, and I've been a little bit of messing around there as well. We'll get into that first. So that's the lengths of our actual components in relation to our tuned length. So lengths here relates to the timing of when our waves arrive at certain RPMs, and calculation of the diffuser cone, actual total length of the diffuser cone, and the angle of the diffuser cone. So as we know, a higher angle will give us a higher signal of a shorter duration, and a lower angle will give us a longer wave of a lower amplitude. So to calculate the length of the wave that we want, because that will be tied to the RPM, as the RPM rises, the arrival of the wave at the right time, we have to know the actual length of the wave and what RPM range it will be useful in, keeping in mind the diffuser gives us our range of power up to our peak, okay, where the baffle cone is at our peak and above. This is up to our peak, so this is the longest range of operation of our engine, the main curve. Now we need to know what the minimum and maximum RPM of that range will be, and for that we need to know the length of our wave. Now if we know the length of our initial wave that comes out of the exhaust, and then we know the taper, the angle, the length of this, the total length of this, we can work out what the length will be of the reflecting wave that comes back. And it basically comes down to basic megaphone calculation, which is that the smallest end is the highest RPM range of the diffuser, and the largest end is the lowest RPM range of the diffuser. Now in more complex ways, we can calculate the original wave length and pressure from the wave, and we can do that by translating the blowdown time. That's the time between when the exhaust port opens and then the subsequent transfer port opens. That's the blowdown period will determine the amount of time that our original wave is. So knowing that, we can calculate the maximum RPM where the head of the wave will be reflected, okay, at this end, and then the minimum RPM, the wave will be reflected, and then plus the wave itself, the wavelength itself. So we're always going from the start end to the start end. So if we were looking at expansion chambers from a point of view of deciding whether we got two pipes that fit the one bike and which one is going to do what, we can have a look at expansion chambers with multi-tapers or even curved, like a top of a wine bottle neck, curved parabolic curves in a pipe, and we can assess what's going on by looking at the ends of the pipe. If we've got a slow taper at this end of the pipe, and then the taper is high at this end of the pipe, well, it means we're pulling a strong wave at the lower RPM range, okay? And when it gets to the high RPM range, we've got a very shallow angle, so the strength of the wave won't be as strong at this end as it will be, now remember this is in timings, okay, as it will be in lower RPM. Whereas if we've got a pipe like this one, which has got a steeper angle early on, okay, and it might be a three-stage or this type diffuser that has a higher angle here and then has lesser angles here, okay, not less than this, but just not as steep a gradient, okay. That means we're getting a stronger signal at our higher RPMs, and then not as quite as strong at our lower RPMs. So a pipe with a more higher angle earlier on in the diffuser and then not so much late in the diffuser is better for top end power, and then a pipe with an angle that's nice and narrow and down at the starting of the diffuser and then gets steeper quite a bit by the end will be better boosting in the diffuser section for low end power. So that's how you can tell simply by looking at the pipe tapers to determine what the characteristics of the pipe are going to be, basically. Now, in later pipes, we get into this type of design, okay, and designing the ratios of these, as in what distance this one has to be from this one and this one, okay, we've got to divide this up into like a percentage of ratios. So it's a percentage of whatever the full length of the taper is compared to a single taper. Now, what we use basically is a calculation which is kind of like a horn. It's called a horn coefficient, and what it does is it gives us the actual degree of exponential curve. So if you want a more exponential curve that's curves like this, okay, then we use a higher coefficient, and then a lower coefficient will just give us a lesser sweeping curve up there. And then what we do is we plot points at percentages along that point, and then we derive, and this is trying to be basically this, okay, but it's just in three stages. So that is in design software, okay, to design a pipe, but from our perspective, we haven't got design software, so we're just looking at what the actual diffuser does in the pipe that we've got, and then what design changes we might want to make. Like, we might want to use a diffuser, a different type of diffuser, and make a different one. So what we could do is we could essentially use the same diameter points along here, the percentage of the diffuser, and then we could increase the angle here a bit and have these angles lesser, and we'd have a pipe that operated a little bit higher in the RPM range. That's just an example, okay? Now that again gets down to the slope, the tapers and the wave slope. So that's how our slopes are affecting our range, okay? And we can calculate the wavelengths and so forth for the timings for that, and we can actually find out what the amount of time our wave lasts for, accurately enough. And then the next thing is our diameters, and our diameters is determined by relationship to the port width and the height, so the port area of the port window. Okay, now if we were designing our own pipe, we would have to include the porting. All those dimensions are taken from the relationship to the port window. Okay, now this is about to 8 minutes now, so I'm going to delay this until the next video, and we'll get into how the diameters are determined here, and the neutral chamber diameter and the outlet pipe diameter, and I also want to show you some diddlings in the software that I've been doing, and yeah, that'll do it for today. Okay, I'll see you in the next video.